When there's a hurricane sitting right offshore, some prepare for the worst, others prepare to surf.
This is a video from Jacksonville Beach. You see the surfers taking advantage of the hurricane swell. We're not going to see really big waves here on the West Coast, but we will get some wind.
NBC2's Emilia Fabiano is live at Blind Pass on Sanibel with the warnings.
Blind Pass Beach is notorious for dangerous rip currents, and with Hurricane Dorian whipping rain and wind bands our way, it's especially dangerous in the water right now, so much so that the National Weather Service is actually warning you of a rip current advisory right now off the coast of Lee and Charlotte counties, but it's not stopping some from enjoying a day on the water off Sanibel Island.
It's perfect. Perfect windsurfing weather.
Taking advantage of the sun and surf.
Work got canceled for 2 days, so I'm down here catching the nice wind with my dad.
Ryan Earl came to Sanibel Island to catch a few waves and escape Dorian creeping towards his Jacksonville home. But even in Southwest Florida, he and others out on the causeway haven't avoided all of the storm's reach.
Yesterday was guys stopped kiting because it was too much wind.
It was a little too strong for us. We packed it in.
They say today is much better, but Lee County officials are warning everyone to heed the NWS rip current advisory.
We train in rip currents all the time.
Tim Barrett with Sanibel Fire and Rescue says anytime the wind picks up from one of Dorian's bands, it'll mean bigger waves and more dangerous rip currents.
And maybe this is a day you just kind of stay on the beach and not go out in the water too much.
Earl says they are being cautious in the swell, trying to enjoy the Sanibel surf while we feel the effects of Dorian from afar.
We're keeping an eye on things. There's supposed to be a band coming in later today. We'll keep our eye on that.
As of the latest advisory from the NWS, Lee and Charlotte counties will be under this rip current warning until tomorrow night. Count on NBC2 to let you know if those conditions do change. Reporting live on Sanibel Island, Emilia Fabiano, NBC2.